All right, let's be real. Everyone thinks they're a hacker these days. You install Kali Linux, run some script you found on Reddit, and suddenly you're in the Matrix. You even set your terminal to green text just to feel like Neo. But let's be honest. If you had to Google how to open terminal, you're probably not as elite as you think. So today, I'm breaking down the 5 levels of hacking, from absolute noob to the kind of ghost that governments are terrified of. And if you're sitting there wondering where you fit in, chances are it's somewhere near the bottom. But don't worry, I'll roast you either way. Before we dive in, let's talk about something important. Some of you are stuck at level 0, crying in Discord servers because your hack Facebook in 5 minutes script didn't work. Some of you think running Metasploit makes you a cyber criminal mastermind when all you really did was copy-paste commands. And I know at least 5 of you just opened ChatGPT to ask, how to be anonymous hacker 2025 tutorial. Look, if you actually want to level up and not just LARP as a hacker, you need real skills. And lucky for you, I run Cyberflow's Academy, where I teach actual hacking that can't be posted on YouTube because YouTube has this weird thing about ethical guidelines or whatever. So if you want to move past the script kiddie who thinks downloading Termux makes them a hacker phase, check it out. First link in the description. All right, let's start with level 0, script kiddies. Yes, the bottom of the barrel. The ones who think downloading Kali Linux automatically grants them hacking powers. They run tools they don't understand, panic when a terminal throws an error, and proudly post screenshots of hacked login pages, when all they really did was inspect element. The closest they've come to hacking was when they guessed their sibling's password because it was literally password 123. They talk about hacking the mainframe without realizing mainframes aren't even a thing anymore. These are the guys who, when asked, "What's an SQL injection?" will say, "Oh yeah, I saw a YouTube video on that once," and then proceed to inject drop table users into a login field. If this is you, don't worry. There's hope. You just need to actually learn what you're doing. Or you know, you can keep running Loic and thinking you're part of Anonymous. Your call. Level 1, the beginner hacker. This is where you actually start learning. Maybe you've figured out that Metasploit isn't hacking, it's just a tool. You've installed Kali Linux, not just for aesthetics, but because you actually want to use Nmap, Burp Suite, and Wireshark. You've probably watched a bunch of tutorials and maybe even tried some basic penetration testing. The problem? You think you're way better than you actually are. This is the Dunning-Kruger level. You've learned enough to feel dangerous, but not enough to realize you still know nothing. You scan a website with Nikto, see some vulnerabilities pop up, and suddenly think you're hacking NASA. But hey, at least you've moved past just blindly running scripts. Progress. Level 2, the CTF player. Congratulations, you're starting to touch real hacking. You've entered the world of capture the flag competitions, where you realize security is way more than just breaking into stuff. You now understand things like SQL injections, XSS, and maybe even SSRF. You've used Burp Suite without needing a tutorial open in another tab, and you know what a reverse shell is without Googling it every 5 seconds. But the real eye-opener is when you do your first CTF and get absolutely destroyed. You thought you were a genius, then you saw some 16-year-old from Ukraine solving challenges in 30 seconds, and now you're questioning your entire life. This is where many people give up, but if you push through, you might just make it to level 3. Level 3, the real-world hacker. This is where things get serious. You're no longer just playing games, you're applying your knowledge in real-world security. Maybe you've done bug bounties, worked on actual penetration tests, or even helped companies secure their systems. You realize hacking isn't about running exploits. It's about understanding how systems work and where they can break. This is also the point where you start getting really paranoid. You no longer trust public Wi-Fi. You assume your phone's microphone is always on, and you've probably considered moving to an off-grid cabin just to avoid government surveillance. Congratulations, you're starting to think like a real hacker. Level 4, advanced hacker slash researcher. You've entered the dark realms of exploit development, reverse engineering, and malware analysis. You don't just use exploits, you write them. You're comfortable in assembly language, and you can debug a binary like it's second nature. At this level, security isn't just a skill, it's an obsession. You're spending late nights analyzing vulnerabilities, reading white papers, and trying to figure out how the hell someone just turned a buffer overflow into full remote code execution. You're no longer just playing the game, you're rewriting the rules. And finally, level 5, the ghost. These are the hackers that exist in whispers. The people you'll never hear about because they don't want to be known. The ones who bypass nation-state firewalls for fun. The ones who write exploits that never see the public eye. If you think you're elite, but your name is known, you're not at this level. The real legends stay hidden. They don't flex their skills on social media. They just exist in the shadows, moving silently, undetected. If you ever reach this level, you won't need me to tell you. You'll just know. So, where do you stand? Are you a script kiddie who still thinks Termux is hacking? a CTF player struggling to solve challenges, or maybe you've made it into real-world security and are now questioning every Wi-Fi network you see. Wherever you are, there's always room to grow. And if you actually want to level up and stop embarrassing yourself in hacking forums, you know where to find me, Cyberflow's Academy, where we teach real hacking, not just how to run scripts. Now, if you'll excuse me, I need to go disappear into the void, because I may have said too much. Peace out.